Okay, so now we're going to get to the big elephant in the room. There is a Jackson Pollock, if you're familiar with the name, found over in Sun City.
Yes.
But it has a big story. It wasn't like, oh, I'm a collector and I have this piece of art.
Yeah, there's a big difference. When someone comes to us and says, oh, look, I found this at a yard sale, which has happened several times in our life, you know, this was totally different. This was truly a lost piece of history. The original owner was the sister of the gentleman whose house we were cleaning out, and they didn't even know it. When she had passed away in 1992, they just put all her stuff into storage and then shipped it. It's been sitting in a garage ever since.
Oh my gosh, here in Sun City?
Yeah, here in Sun City, but she was a major well-known art collector, friends with every major artist. I mean, literally, Peggy Guggenheim was a regular, she knew everyone. She was so connected, and the story of her life unfolded, and then the art started to really tell the story.
So this is a picture of the Jackson Pollock. But tell me, so first of all, tell me, when you open up the door and you see that, do you know instantly what you're looking at?
No, as a matter of fact, as we went through the art, there were about 12 pieces of art in the house, and it was Kenneth Nolan. Some of these are not household names. Kenneth Nolan, Jules Olitsky, but they were all in this same circle of artists. And as we were going through them and researching and contacting the different foundations, this piece was just leaning up against the wall for a couple of months in our gallery, and I just went, God, that looks like a Jackson Pollock. Wouldn't that be funny? And every story, everything kept pointing, this is Jackson Pollock, this is a Jackson Pollock. So then we hired a forensic scientist to test the paint, to date it, so we knew exactly when it would have been created. And the experts, every person that saw it just went, oh my goodness, that's a Jackson Pollock.
Let's say it would have been easy had he signed it,
yeah.
But he didn't.
Oh yeah.
So that's why you had to go through all this rigmarole.
Yeah, but in searching his catalog resume of known works, it kept leading us to this one, and that's the story. I mean, it's a movie. The woman's life, to me, is so more exciting because it folds like a Netflix series. I mean, it's
last question. It's really, what's the value on that?
We're estimating it because of its condition. Again, because it's been sitting in a garage in Sun City, it has some heavy damages to it. It needs to be professionally restored, which we dare not do to it. We estimate 10 to 15 million, but it could surprise us.
$15 million was sitting in a storage unit over in Sun City.
I mean,
what if it was like Storage Wars and you bid $100 on that thing and got it?
Oh,
ooh,
yeah. Oh,
get
and
the
see,
vapors.
The thing is, it actually might have headed to the dumpster. Because literally we were cleaning the house out and just getting anything that was saleable. And literally, if it didn't speak to everybody that was in the room, it would have hit the dumpster.
It just goes to show you want to head over to Jay Levine's in North Scottsdale so that you can get your stuff appraised, because you might have $50 million sitting somewhere. We'll be right back.
Thanks.